So we're going to go ahead and go right on back in. But like I said, sometimes you can get with a guy and he's stuck. And I want you to understand is, y'all understand what a covering is. A covering is going to be above you. You can't be covered by something that's beneath you. Because when God speaks of a covering, he's talking about covering your authority, your head. He's talking about covering you all the way. So in order for somebody to cover me, they can't be beneath me. So a lot of times what happens when it comes to guys, women will sit back and they get to this level right here. And they say, God, send me a husband. God, send me a husband. And God says, no, not yet. Because the guy that I send you, if you get somebody in this level, you're going to get somebody who can't cover you in a year or two. He's not going to be able to cover you in a year or two. So you end up, a lot of women go into rebellion. So they go and get their own man who's at that level because they get somebody they can relate to in that season. And they think that he's going to be able to continue to cover them. And then God does one thing that it really confuses them. God doesn't stop blessing him. He doesn't take the anointing away. He doesn't remove his spirit from him. He continues to use him, and he starts to grow that woman. And when she grows, now she's at this place and the man's here. He can't cover her. So the first thing he begins to do is try to bring her back down because he can't relate to her. They can't walk together. They how can a house divided cannot stand. So now you got her tugging on him, trying to pull him up, and you got him tugging on her, trying to bring her down. And they end up in this relationship where there's all this contention and all this fighting because she found a man in the midst of her comfort zone. And God was saying to her, I didn't want you to get a man right then and there because this man wasn't assigned to you. So now you that came into his comfort zone, and guess what? He didn't. This isn't just his comfort zone, but this is the place where he settled. Because some people settle in the comfort zone. This is where he settled. He don't plan on going any further than this. So guess what? You're gonna have a choice. Either you're gonna have to go there and stay there with him and get stuck and be miserable for the rest of your life, and you will still have, but you will have your man, or you're gonna have to come out of that place. And when coming out of that place, you got to keep growing, which means that eventually, if the man doesn't go, if he doesn't come into Christ and, let God move him, you're going to get to the place where your languages are confused. You're going to get to the place where the two of you can no longer walk together. And that's why God said, if the unbelieving want to depart, let him depart. What God is saying is don't go down there trying to catch him. Because sometimes when you're dealing with an unbeliever, what has to happen is you don't go back. You go down to try to get him. And the thing is, in order to get him, you have to come outside the will of God. And God says, no. Let the unbeliever depart. If the unbeliever want to depart, that means the unbeliever has chosen. He's made a choice. Or she for the guys. This unbeliever has made a choice. So God is saying, I don't want you stuck. I don't want you to get to a place where, you get a man in his mindset. And it's the same thing for guys. A guy can go and get a woman in the mindset. And I've actually seen this with men. Where a man can get a woman while he's in a mindset, and that woman has a low budget mindset, understand that she's a helpmeet. She may not be able to help with $1 million because her mind ain't there. You see, the thing is, she's only limited. God won't put more on you than you can bear, even financially. Some people can't bear to be rich. They couldn't handle it. So that man goes out there and chooses a woman who can only handle making $50,000 a year. She can't go above $50,000 a year. And some guys that go and choose women who can't even handle making over $25,000 a year. He gets stuck. So now he can't move because of the woman that he's with. Because of the woman. The woman is stuck. The woman can't come outside of that. Her house is dirty. She ain't cleaning herself up. The house ain't organized. And all she's doing is putting on weight. And all she's doing is fattening him up. But she's stuck. She's stuck in a mindset. And God is saying, this wasn't the woman I wanted to assign him to because of the mindset. She got this $25,000 mindset, this poverty mindset, and she can't handle it. God won't put more on you than you can bear. He won't even give you more money than you can handle. That's one of the things he blessed me with. He said, I won't even give you more money than you can handle. Some people can't handle to be a millionaire. The man has a millionaire anointing on his life, but he can't be a millionaire because of the woman he chose. Because of the woman that he settled down with because of the helpmeet. The helpmeet couldn't help him with $1 million. So God couldn't send him $1 million. So God had to end up letting that man make $25,000 a year because that's all his wife could handle. That's all his wife could bear. And he ends up being stuck, and he knows that he could do more. He can go and do greater things, but he's stuck, and he doesn't know why. He says, I'm in the will of God. I'm faithful to my wife. I do this and I do that. But he's stuck because of the woman that he chose for himself. He's stuck because that woman's mindset, she's stuck at $25,000 a year. Same thing, ladies. You can sit back and you can get with a man who's stuck. You may have a millionaire anointing on your life. You may even have a billionaire's anointing on your life. And you end up with a man who's stuck. And then God can't bless you because of the man you chose. And you wonder why God makes you wait a lot of times, because you want to choose a man from your comfort zone. You wonder why you have to wait. You wonder why some women have to wait 10, 15, 20 years to get a husband. You don't have to wait that long. It's because they won't come out their comfort zone, because they won't shift. They still hanging around the same old people doing the same old thing. I'm not against being loyal, but one thing I've learned is that loyalty means that you got to be around the people who's already, who's not the type of people who get comfortable somewhere and get stuck. God will place you in the midst of people who, you know, they're shifting with you. They're constantly shifting. And, you know, every time you look around, they shifting and you shifting. And all y'all are shifting. See, that's what God wants to do. Or sometimes you may come in contact with people, iron sharp as iron. You may notice that your friend is getting a little stuck, and God will use you to speak. But because they trust the anointing on your life and they trust the God in you, then they'll move too. And see, that's the thing. God doesn't want you to get stuck. Your comfort zone, it only allows you to relate to certain type of people. That's why some women say, I'm so tired of meeting the same type of man. You in a different, you in a comfort zone where there's a certain type of man there. And it ain't the men. The problem is you. You're still at that place where you can only afford that type of mindset. That's the only man who can actually relate to you. So God says, I want to move you. And then some of you complain about your friends. You keep getting the same type of friends because you're in a mindset. How can two walk together except they be agreed? You're in a mindset that only allows people to have a certain way of thinking to be around you. And God says, I want to shift you. I want to move you to a better place. But he can't move you because you sitting back here in a mindset. Now you got all these friends around you who got locks on you. And that's why I tell people, y'all hear me when I say this. That's why I tell people, don't ever get to the place where you get comfortable in a mindset. Don't get comfortable in middle class. Don't even get comfortable becoming a millionaire. You can become a millionaire. Don't get comfortable there, because you got to understand that you can become a multimillionaire. Then you can become a billionaire. You never get comfortable. That's why I tell people all the time, this is what you need to do. For those of you, you know, you may find yourself, you got limited income or what have you. This is what you do. You come out of agreement with the people on that level. Come out of agreement with them. If you want to be shifted, come out of agreement. And the way you come out of agreement is you get more wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Start buying books of people who have a mindset that God has shifted, so that you can come in and you can begin to take in that wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And you start coming out of that mindset. And I'm going to tell you what else you start doing. Start traveling. Get up and go to some other countries. Get around folks you can't relate to. That's how you shift financially. People think that I just need to go to college. I just need to do this. I just need to do that. And I just need to go. No, what you need to do is come out of agreement with them. That's all you got to do. God delivered me from a lot of folks. We didn't even have to have an argument. He delivered me from just simply by pulling me out that mindset. Went to the point where we couldn't agree anymore. Pulling me out of a mindset that allowed them to come into my life. Then we get on the phone and our conversations are strange. We sitting up on the phone. What you doing? Girl, nothing. I call you back. Because we can't talk no more. We sitting up on the phone like, this is weird. You know, but then God turned around and he started putting me in contact with people that were busy. Like me, I'm a busy person. God started putting me in contact with people who were busy, people who didn't need my time every day, people who were constantly shifting, people who they knew how to cover me, they knew how to pray for me and intercede for me, and I could do it for them. He started putting me in contact with people like that, and it was a foreign thing for me. So I want you to understand that God wants to constantly shift you, but in order for him to shift you, you got to let him change your mind where you are. Don't wait for him to take you to a certain place. That's where people get stuck in a comfort zone, because they get there and they keep on waiting for change. They keep waiting on change, and you know, and I'm going to tell you, they keep on following a lot of false prophets. There are some true prophets out there who will preach, but they end up following a lot of false prophets who are constantly saying, God's about to shift you, God's about to move, and they hit like on their statuses and sharing, yay. You ain't going nowhere until this right here changes. Until this here changes, you ain't going nowhere. In order for God to shift you, he shifts you by your mind. This is what takes you. This right here is your vehicle, people of God. This is your vehicle. So don't get caught up in that. Oh, if I like his status, then that mean the prophecy is for me. If I share his status, then his status is going to come to pass in my life. You ain't going nowhere until this shifts. You ain't going nowhere until you come out of agreement with the people that's on your level. Come out of agreement with them. I'm not saying get around folks and try to intentionally come out of agreement. I'm saying move to another mindset. That's how you know you shifted. Keep shifting in your mind. Keep letting God take you up.